Yip, yip, da hooty, got me a beauty.
Bracket is titled Prospect, and so I just want to get started, and I think that it will speak for itself. So,
interior, Prospect, California, 1940s. It is a dreary northern central California December. Frankie, a grease monkey, tolls away underneath a Chrysler. The radio plays that American songbook standard.
Accentuate the positive, evil in. Line it to negative, latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. You got to spread your up to the maximum.
I wasn't going to anyways. This crisis has to put your school out. It's still slobber knocking all over my mug.
Or pandemonium.
Got your little cows and toe against your leg.
Right. To illustrate.
Plus car.
Billing canals.
Yeah,
it should be right. What did they do when everything looked so dark?
Hey, Adelina. About time you showed up here. I'm going to the record you found another machine head shop that you hideout in. You needed less of a give-a-ding-dang dance than I have. I wasn't looking forward to being jealous of old Hank over on Main Street or Harry with the kid's leg.
We could never step out on you, Frankie.
Yeah, you know we only got eyes for you, you greasy hot tomato, you.
You
glad? He's always underneath one job.
He could have two heads for all we know. One is gorgeous as the next.
He does have two heads. I've seen him. But the head on the right pinch hits for the ugly ones. Old left is quite the looker, though.
What the heck?
Chuck, you gotta keep up, my boy. The cracks fly quick and loose around you.
Well, my stepdad certainly do.
Class, Eugene? Just because we're in a shop that's both dirty and crude doesn't mean our minds have to be. No offense, Frankie.
None taken.
Say, Frankie, where's your own? Powder room? Blue. No, John.
Well, we haven't quite restocked our perfumes. And our bidet could use a bit of a scrubbing.
It's fine.
Pisser's right down the hall on the right.
Get a load of Princess Lottie Dow over there. Like, bathrooms? Are you kidding me? Look at me. Bow before me. Hey, Jeeves, why don't you light me a 25-cent cigar and light it with a $2 bill, would you? Maybe I was ragging on Maid Mary in there, but any of you grouchos got a stogie anywhere? Because I'm feeling one.
Are you familiar, Chick? Really smoke cigars?
Oh, no, Chucky, no cigars, just cigarettes, like your doctor recommended.
Yeah, he's like a little puppy. You want one of Dr. Pavlov's ciggies? Do ya? Go fetch, good boy. And by the way, Marion isn't that bad. I mean, does she act too good for us losers? Sure, but that's because she probably is. Hell, she definitely is. I mean, just look at us.
Whoa, no chucking way there, man. You just crossed the line in the sand. You're dead,
police. I'm sorry,
but I'm gonna hit you so hard that when you come to, I'm gonna rough you up.
I mean, we truly don't deserve the company of earning a statue.
The love of money is the root of all kinds of evil.
Whoa there, Edgardo Allan Poe. That was somehow even darker than the Marion Malarkey Eugene was shuffling.
And I didn't think that was possible.
Go back to your journal, Tess. Say, Randall, it doesn't take a big block engine to run that hot. For you, I mean.
The hell you want about, Joe?
Marion's got it bad for you. Now, I'm just saying you haven't caught on to that? Ixay, we'll talk later.
No, you can talk now. I apparently have places to be. Now, what was it? Tennis lessons at the country club, a polo match on the grounds of the country club, swimming in a pool full of money at the country club. I can never quite remember. I'll have to ask the manservant, what did you say his name was? Jeeves? Well, I'll have you know, my servant is a pervert, and her name is Arabella.
Marion, wait, I don't know what you heard from the wings, but you got it all wrong. No one was beseeching your girl.
It's fine, I really must go.
Marion, seriously.
It's fine. What are we doing? Such a flam. Buy for a boy, slung it, and dive just to impress him? What would father say? me associating with lowly, utterly deprived, bottom-feeding pieces of
Sure, what's up, Doc?
Ah!
You know, I was joking about the bidet stuff before, but as a matter of fact, something is up that one's keister.
Jiminy Christmas! I gotta go turn in my chemistry presentation. The coach won't let me play. Like you say, Joe, enough hooky adventures. Of course, the malt shop's on the way. Buy you one?
Sure. So what do you say, Frankster? Need anything else from me?
How's about handing me that number 5 court box? And the word, Joe, that you will start living up to your potential. Now I am your pa.
Well, hey now, Frank, I wouldn't be so sure about that. Me and my sis, our moms, well, she was a bit of a booze fool back in the roaring 20s, if you know what I'm saying. So it wouldn't surprise me one bit if her and old Frankie got up to a bit of the old.
Now I ain't your pa, but pounding around with an old, stinky wrench knocker like me is the most worst bad decision a shining star like you could ever make.
Frankie, I don't know what to say. So same time tomorrow?
Bet your ass. See you then.
Did she really say she had a hermit servant? I mean, the very hell was that?
Yes, I believe she did. No, sir, couldn't get crazier in our life.
Hey, Hazel.
So, Eugene?
So that chocolate malt sounded pretty good, you know? You a big fan of the chocolate fudgy double scoop McGilligan?
I wouldn't know. I'm something of a, more than something of a homebody.
Okay, I get it. You've been saving them pennies and dimes in your allowance, right?
Right.
So, your treat.
After you.
Bells, ho,
happy ho, for
J-I-N-G-L-E. Bells, ho, happy J-I-N-G-L-E. B-E-L-L-S, I love those J-I-N-G-L-E.
Please excuse the interruption, this just in. Breaking urgent news has just come across our news desk. We take you now live to the halls of Congress where President Franklin Delano Roosevelt is preparing to address the nation.
Mr. Speaker, members of the Senate, of the House of Representatives, yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace
Infamy
with that nation.
Deliberately attacked our boys in the Pacific.
And at the solicitation.
Joe! I gotta tell Joe! And Randy and the gang!
In conversation.
I gotta tell my friends! Hey, Joe! Randy!
And its emperor, looking toward the maintenance of peace in the Pacific. Indeed, 1 hour.
Thank you all for coming so much. It was a very hard and very interesting 2.5 months.
working on this. So we really appreciate all of you guys coming, and we hope you guys enjoy Forever Blue and Prospect. Thank you, guys.